Hey everybody, this is your boy Jake Casada. I'm brand new to YouTube. This is one of my first videos, and I'd really would like the likes on this. I would like 10 likes. We'll start small. I'd appreciate it, and I appreciate all the support. Add me on Madden or anything. Be nice to play you guys. So we'll see how it goes. So today we are doing a draft of champions. Hopefully we can get a most feared. Like, I'm talking like a Brandon Marshall or a Clay Matthews or Marshawn Lynch. Those kind. So we'll see how it goes. And here we go. So let's see who we get. The thing is, a lot of people have been talking about the Andy Reid lately because they say he was good with the pass rush and everything. But the Bengals have Man and Long, so that's good. So I think I'm going to hit the Bengals on this one. So generate base team. Okay. So far in the first round, we got a pretty good team, or a pretty good round so far. Let's see, Tim Jennings, I think I should go with the William Hayes team. Oh wait, but his finesse move is bad, so I think I'm going to hit up the Tim Jennings on this one. With the 87 zone and the 85 man, I think he'd be a good addition to the team. I think it's pretty obvious here. I like the Patriots, so I'll go for the Dante Hightower.
And that's a pick that'll solve a lot of problems out there. He'll fit in nicely.
All right, so I will go. This is a tough one because these are really good cards. I'd go for the J.R. Sweezy because he's got 88 run block, but his pass block's pretty bad. But I don't really need a receiver. I don't know. Leave the comments if you think I should have picked J.R. Sweezy or Marvin Jones, because I don't think I need a quarterback right now. But I'm gonna pick up Marvin Jones for this round. Okay, so for round four we got Philip Rivers, Joe Staley, and Jonathan Stewart. I think we'll find out a quarterback early on in this draft, but I think for now we're going to hit up the Jonathan Stewart.
And there's a pick that'll certainly help.
So
maybe
we'll pick
him
up.
Signing,
and I think it's pretty self-explanatory here. I think I'm going to hit up the Jordan Reed team of the week. I mean, he's 6'3", pretty good. His run blocking's not good, but I mean, his other catching traffic's huge for me, so I'm gonna hit up Jordan Reed. So far, we're doing good. I don't know how to say his name. Corey Graham. Okay, so I think it's pretty good so far. So I would go with, I'm gonna, a 96 pursuit, 96. That's a good card, but I already have it right outside linebacker, so I think I'm going to hit up the cornerback again.
Because
I think Corey Graham's a very good cornerback. I mean, a lot of people doubt him.
I'm not so sure on that one.
Honey Badger. That's a really good card to have. So I think I'm going to hit the Honey Badger, because, I mean, he's pretty good. Pretty OP card. And we
Where
hit a Jason Pierre-Paul, Jonathan Joseph, or Gerard Mayo.
Or can really help you out
the linebacker core, we definitely need help on. But I think we need to get spread to our D-line as well. So we're going to go with Jason Pierre-Paul.
Over what was there before.
Two Seahawks players, Byron Maxwell, Bruce Irvin, Brandon Spikes. We got two cornerbacks so far, so I'm going to hit the left outside linebacker on this one, because Bruce Irvin Carter is pretty good, so I would highly suggest getting him. Boy, it's finger crossing okay. Time now with the round 10 and a few more holes Gary to Hughes. Fill. You've got to be hoping DJ Carey, still a gem or two that becomes available. This is a really kind of crappy round. I'm gonna probably go for the cornerback. Probably my third stringer. And oh, okay, most feared. We got him. But that's, I want the high elite most feared. James Arvidejo, Ryan Matthews, and Greg Toler. I think I'm gonna go for the strong safety because that's my only excellent piece of the puzzle selection. I'm missing at the moment. Maybe get him over the hump. Oh, these are good. Blanton. I'm gonna get a defensive tackle for round 12. Floyd. And okay.
How about that?
Let's see, I think we need a center. We got a tight end. You really don't need a fullback. You're not gonna really use a fullback that much, but it'd be nice. But we're gonna get the center with the 85 pass block and 94 run block. So we're gonna pick him up.
Kind of an interesting choice there. I'm not
Max Hunter,
that he's gonna 14. The system they plan on running.
Oh, Calais Campbell. Calais Campbell, Thomas Davis. I think we're gonna pick up the Calais Campbell. I think he'd be a huge addition to the team. And how about our D-line as well? And our legends.
It's pretty much
really
a coin
good.
Flip,
so,
if you ask me.
We got Brian Finneran, Gilbert Brown, or John Elway. See, I think we need some serious help on this. So, I believe we should go for the Brian Finneran. I mean, look at that. He's got 97 jump. I think that's a good card. We can't just have one guy out there doing all the work. I mean, Matt Castle, he's okay at quarterback. He's not the worst. But we can, I think we should be able to cut away with Brian Finneran. So we're going to pick him up as well.
Boy, you talk about a friendly turn of the cards. This is a great
that is our
guys,
draft.
A dynamic player right here.
Leave a comment below if you feel like it. We have an 81 overall, 79 defense, 79 offense, my bad, and 82 defense. Yeah, that's the end of the video right there. Short and sweet. Leave a like on the video, or leave a comment. If I get 10 likes, I will do more videos, and I will choose one person out of those likes to give an elite card away. So that will end next week. So I will see you guys next week.